A lot of people look at me and be like, aren't you too small to play rugby? I feel a bit transformed. It's like I'm no longer Izzy, who likes to make breakfast for her wife and play with the cats and everything. It's Izzy, and I can turn into an animal, and that's what rugby lets you do. Yeah, I remember elementary school, middle school, like wanting to spend more time with some girls, and not just because we were friends. Like, that's something like that happened that you're just like, oh, I get butterflies. And you're like, oh no, she's my best friend. And then she starts to date a boy and you cry. And then why are you crying? I remember I started to like have really depressive symptoms. Like I would sleep for 14 hours a day, which was not healthy. And I think that was something that kind of colored also like my first 2 years of college. That also coincided with meeting my first girlfriend. And for a couple months, like, she would not go out with me because she was like, you're a mess, no. And that was a little bit, I was like, oh, hey now, I have to get my shit together. I don't have anything to hold back. When I get out on the pitch, I don't have to worry if something slips or if there's a crack in the facade. And the more secure I feel in myself, the better I play. My two parents are Brazilian. For me, it was a lucky thing to have dual citizenship and having these like two identities, I guess. Marjorie and I met through my whole process to come to Brazil for a test period with the national team. She was team manager at the time. I was like seeing the physio after one of our practices and she was reading a book and I just like tried to start a conversation. I was like, oh, do you like books? Man, I'm the worst flirt ever. I found that I love myself more and I'm proud of who I am and that we can also find new ways to love each other. That's a learning process as well. And it's not to say I wasn't happy for moments in high school or college, but there's a Brazilian poet who says that you can make happiness routine. And that's the sort of thing that Marjorie and I are after, that we can be happy in the smallest ways and in everyday ways. At the 2016 Olympics, it was an important moment because my Olympic dream had come true, but Marjorie's as well, because she was part of the organizing committee. It had been a long day. I'd already competed in my last game earlier that day and like watched the rest of the matches and then the medal ceremony. And we went out onto the empty pitch and she started talking, but suddenly like my team had moved to the side and I was standing alone. But I was like, oh, what's happening now? And then I just heard her say, and I have an important question for someone. And I was crying. I was crying. And I was like, oh, yes, I already know. And she was saying more things. And I was like, just hand me the mic. I already know what I'm going to say. And then it took a while like to understand the impact of that. Like people finding us on Facebook and just sending us messages and be like, thanks for doing that. Like I felt so represented for the first time at the Olympic Games. I realized that if I had seen that growing up, what a world of difference it would have made for me.